Sonic News! A new show appears! It's super effective! I am SSF. Hi. Pull my finger, please. Please? No? Screw you. I was polite. Ugh.
Welcome to Sonic Land.
Live from the magnificent state of Virginia, here's your host, the news dude of Sonic Paradox, Sonic Sega Fan 1991.
Oh wait, that's me. No. Yeah, really, it's me. Hey guys, it's SSF here with a new Sonic News Show. Welcome to the Sonic News Show. The first one of March. Weehee. I'm happy. I really am. Talk about, I think it was 2 weeks ago I last did the Sonic News Show. And a lot has happened in 2 weeks. It's just remarkable how things can change in the span of just 2 weeks. It's pretty crazy. If you're wondering what I'm doing here, I'm just... Okay, let me explain. I was actually watching a stream...
I don't know why it's not opening up.
...of Turbo. Yes, Turbo, SegaSonic Radio, and, what was it, Sonic Stadium, yeah, I was watching his stream, and it just so happens, go figure, that I remember the show right in the middle of it. Yeah, I remember his stream right in the middle of it. I should still be heard clear as day.
Okay, there we go.
Feel free to tune in on his stream if you wish. While listening to me. Technically, you only have to listen to me. You don't really need to watch, so to speak, but listening to me makes a difference. It is twitch.tv/TurboDriveLive, with no spaces. You can go there if you wish to watch the stream. Alright. And now I shall go ahead and actually do my show, because I see I don't really have that many viewers. Yeah, I don't even have that many viewers, which is kind of funny. But now you should be able to see, there you go, what I had up just a bit ago. But yeah. Funny thing is, Turbo actually has more viewers than me, and he's playing Sonic Heroes on Super Hard Mode right now. Yeah, he's got more viewers than me, which is what I expected. It's just still funny, I don't understand why I have more followers than him.
Yeah, you can fuck yourself. Alright.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't get it, but,
Oh, great. Hello, to everyone who's listening in on, what is it,
Wait. Yeah, tune in on this.
Hey, extra life, thank God. So I got 19 now. Yeah. For those who are listening on the Sonic Paradox podcast live stream, then
Sonic News Show. He means
viewing or watch or listening to me playing through Super Hard Mode on Sonic Heroes and. Yeah, it's not fantastic.
It isn't. It hasn't been going well for him, but if you really wish, I'm going to go ahead and, I'm keeping his stream on, but I'm going to make sure you guys hear me loudest, because technically I am supposed to be doing a show, so bear with me. It's kind of difficult to concentrate on two things all at once, but,
Yes, Knuckles, they have. Right, okay. Glide.
But yeah, topic list. Let me see. That is not what I meant to do. Let me pan in on the,
And nothing. Nope, nothing here. Okay.
Bear with me. I'm just, you know,
and couldn't get that light speed dash, so never mind. And just slowly getting up there. Okay.
Alright. That's still a little too far in. I'm trying to make it so you guys can't see the topic list, because, you know, I'm going to be talking about it anyway. I don't know.
No.
But yeah, bear with me if Turbo Stream is a little too loud. My apologies if that is the case.
That was 33 deaths.
He's feeling pretty badly, but I wouldn't have done any better. I'll say that much. But anyway, let me go ahead and get to the topic list. Main topic tonight.
Lord, my volume.
English Sonic 4 Episode 2 site is up. It doesn't really have much with it, other than some songs, basically. Music, nothing else. I mean, like, we do now know a little bit more about the story. Apparently, the Little Big Planet is back. It has actually returned.
Okay, why are you doing that?
It's pretty crazy. Like, I don't understand. Like, I really don't. Like, it's kind of baffling, to say the least.
God damn it.
But,
okay, for some reason,
It's kind of crazy.
Just, for some reason, Knuckles loves going for the cannons on the side. I don't know why he wants to, but he's auto-locked to the cannons.
Tell me if you really don't want to see the stream, or don't want to hear the voice of Turbo in the background, and I will adjust it as such, because I know it might be loud. And I'm apologize for that. I figured you guys want something different other than this freaking newscaster thing that's always in the background and it's kind of, you know, kind of just sitting there. But other than that, everything should be fine. Broken Wavelength, this is actually a stream I was in the middle of watching before I started the Sonic News show, and I didn't really want to. I felt, you know, it's of Turbo, of SegaSonic Radio and Sonic Stadium, and he's playing Sonic Heroes in super hard mode. This will be a fun little. It's kind of cool how this is. It's kind of cool, but if it gets in the way, I can easily mute his voice and pull the stream away if need be. Just gotta tell me if it's in the way, that's all. But unless you guys don't, I'll keep it there, because he does want viewers, and I do feel bad for how the way things have been going for him in the game today. But he's playing super hard mode on Sonic Heroes, everyone's favorite mode. But anyway, moving on, second topic. Or no, not second topic yet, there's still more in the first one. Just music. But yeah, he does know about the stream. He even greeted you all, so. Anyway, Game Informer. Game Informer. Game Informer has posted a preview of Sonic 4 Episode 2. It's a very positive preview. I mean, it's a very, very positive preview. And I'm happy about it. I still don't know where all the viewers are. I guess it's just because it's a real unusual Saturday, maybe. I don't know. But, yeah. Sonic 4 Episode 2 preview was pretty much it was positive. Where it had, like, it hinted very well that the physics had been completely fixed in the game, and everything was just the way it was supposed to. And even the level design they made was pretty nice. So they're pretty positive about the game, but cautiously positive. I don't know why they're cautiously positive, considering Generations and Colors, and they both have kind of proven that Sega has kept the hype, has kept the games, you know, they're still making the games good. It's not that big of a deal. I don't see the problem. Like, it's pretty crazy how great the games have gotten in the past few years. So even Unleashed to a degree is good. I mean, But then again, we've talked about it on Least Like Crazy last week, and I ranted about it. And considering I'm going to be ranting again in a second, yeah, not going to get into that. So I'm going to completely ignore all of that. Again, I'll inform if anyone feels like the stream you're seeing is in the way, tell me. I'm going to turn up the stream a little bit because I do want to keep hearing his voice, but I want to make sure you guys can hear me. His voice is still pretty... His voice does get loud when he... through the stream, the audio, as he's getting... You know, something's happening, like, right now. So, again, bear with me if it's getting to the point where it's overlapping my voice to the, where you can't hear me. And like I said, if that's the case, tell me and I'll turn it down a bit. Just saying. Either that or I can adjust my mic in Procaster. Also, I can now inform you guys about I don't even know what I'm out of it now. I was I now have a Newgrounds account. SS7981 is my Newgrounds account. I now have a Newgrounds account. Feel free to check it out if you need to. Just note that there really isn't anything on there. Just saying. Now, as for number two, Raging Time! Woohoo! There we go. Game Trailers has rated Sonic number one on their worst blockbuster list. Yeah, the Sonic franchise is number one on their top 10 worst blockbusters list. Why that is, I don't know. But they have their reasonings. Their reasons. And let me explain what it is. What they are. For one thing, they blame Sonic. Well, for one thing, they listed Sonic the franchise as a whole in there. Why that is, I don't know. Why did they list the Sonic franchise in there when it's supposed to be blockbusters as in one game. That's one error right there.
I could drop off and go on to there, but I don't want to.
That's error number one. Error number two is the games they listed. They listed Sonic 06. They listed Unleashed. They listed the Mario and Sonic games. They listed Sonic Adventure 2. Why did they list Sonic Adventure 2? Why did they list the Mario and Sonic games? The Mario and Sonic games are technically not Sonic games. They're Mario games too, people. So technically, if you're listing the Mario and Sonic games as bad blockbuster games, you're also listing the Mario games as bad blockbuster games. The hell? I mean, really? That's the worst thing you could do. Those are not Sonic games. And then they list Unleashed as a bad game, when coincidentally they said they even made Game Trailer. Game Trailers themselves listed it as a good game. As a good game. And then they may say it's a bad game in the freaking countdown. How does that work? It's contradicting. And then they're stuck on Sonic 06, like, people, Sonic 06. Sonic 06 was 5 years ago. 6 years ago. That shouldn't even be a problem now. Why is that being mentioned? Why is Sonic 06 still in Game Trailers' mind 6 years after it happened? We've now gotten better games since then. What the hell, Game Trailers? Just what the hell? And the most stupid thing of all is they think it's well-deserved. It's not well-deserved at all. Not even close. What the hell were they smoking when they made this list? I mean, it didn't help that some other games didn't really deserve it either. I'd have to go back to the video itself to see, but god damn it, Game Trailers, why? Just why are you so ignorant along with so many other critics? Why are these critics so stupid? I mean, it's... They're supposed to be knowledgeable about this shit, yet they seem to have some kind of I want to say bias, but I think it's still kind of not really a bias. But they still seem to have some kind of problem with Sonic. And it's just irking me to no end how shitty this site is with Sonic. It's just, what the fuck? I mean, why the hell can't they just Just stop. Just game trailers, really. If you're not going to treat Sonic like he's supposed to, treat him fairly, then don't treat him at all. Don't even talk about him. Along with many other critics, I could say the same. Many other critics, I could say, if you're just going to have a freaking grudge with Sonic, just don't talk about Sonic at all, or review him, because your shitty-ass reviews and opinions on him, and yes, I did say shitty opinions, because they're not really opinions. They treat them as if they're a fact, when they're not. But their shitty-ass views on Sonic are not deserving in a game, or in a review. It's just another reason why I don't trust critics. I judge the games how I judge them. If the game just happens to be, horrible, it's horrible. And it's not because of them, it's because of me. If I think a game's horrible, I think it's horrible. If other people disagree, fine with me, you know? I don't have a problem with that. But I'm not gonna let some critics tell me what a game is like. I'm not gonna tell them what I should play and what I shouldn't play. I'm just saying. I have my own standards on the game, and you guys have your own standards on the game, but that's fine with me. You know, I don't have any problem with that. I just hate the way these critics just... It's just... fucking hell. Really, game? I mean, not game, but, because I was playing Mario Kart Wii earlier, and it's still pissed at that, but, just... Really, game trailers. Really, just... Come on! It doesn't help. It really doesn't. I really am amazed I don't have more viewers in this, but I'm not exactly surprised. But nevertheless, moving on. As we see Turbo die again, unfortunately. He's still struggling. But looks like he's nearly done, actually. I think this is the last stage, I think.
Just able to get triangle jumps done, but
I'm just utterly disgusted at game trailers. I really am.
Son of a... Oh, there it is.
But on side note, Sonic Generations is now $10 on Steam. Go wild. I don't know if that still applies though. Haven't checked yet. Haven't checked since this was known earlier this week.
This is the last stage, so...
Really steep here. Be careful. Got it.
I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm just speaking to... I'm chatting with you guys, and I'm also chatting with the guys that are in the in Turbo stream at the same time. So if I'm kind of going back and forth and getting quiet because I'm typing.
Come on, let me change character.
If the stream is too loud or in the way, I do apologize. Just tell me if it is. Also, apparently there are 3 new Crush 40 songs in the works. Happy days! After that horrible discussion, hang on, I'm gonna do this because I need to bring up exactly what the names of the songs are, because I'm an idiot and can't remember, just like I was an idiot and nearly forgetting about this, the show in the first place.
There we go. Okay.
Oh god, I don't know where I'm gonna find it. Give me a moment, gotta find it. Gotta find it.
Come on, give me
gotta find it.
Give me Team Blast. Give me a Team Blast. There we go.
Give me a moment. I'm looking. Feel free to keep listening to Turbo stream since he's speaking right now. Where the hell is it? Okay, I can't trust that, so I'm definitely gonna have to go. I'm gonna go with Sonic Rex because I think they have the name too. I mean, I think they have the stuff about the songs as well. You can see how unprepared I am, and it happens often. Like, I didn't have, I completely forgot about it going to... Hang on. Where is it? Crush 40.
Oh,
But yeah, this Yeah, there we go. Okay. Oh, damn it, that's Steam. That is Steam. That is not what I'm trying to bring up. And apparently it didn't search either. There we go. Okay. There's what I'm looking for. Weehee. Alright. So, in case you guys need to be known, we're not going to be talking about the, the stream's going to be away for at the moment.
Bullet bills and stuff like that. And wall jump.
There they are. Leave them to me, Sonic. Never mind.
This game would be fucking unplayable without, you know.
Let me see. Where the hell is? I apologize, guys. I really do. If this is a shitty way this is going. Okay. Here we go. With the I'm all set. But yeah, we have three Crush 40 songs in the works. They have three Crush 40 songs in the works. Three new ones. I'm so pumped about these. The first one is Rise Again. The description is this. We've all known people who hit what I call lows in their life. This song is about crawling out of the dark and into the light. Because just when you feel you are in the worst place in your life, there is always an opportunity to rise again. Rise Again, that actually sums me up a bit. Because I kind of rose again in the midst of horrible times a couple years ago to end up in the place I am now. It's amazing how far I've come, but anyway. Sonic Youth is the next one. This song is about the dedicated Crush 40 fans who believe in our music every year. We live for the music, we live for the thrill of the game, we are the Sonic Youth. And then there was also One of Those Days. Sometimes you wake up and start the day walking into walls. Everything you do is wrong. You tip on your own feet. Trip on your own feet. You drop your cell phone in the toilet. No matter what you do, it keeps happening. There's only one way to fix it all, and that's for the day to just end. So when it happens to you, write it off for one of those awful days. One of those days. Yeah, all three of those songs those just got me to a T. But back to our Turbo Cam. Yeah, we're gonna go with it. Call it the Turbo Cam. Yeah, I'm calling this a Turbo Cam now because I just can. So, yeah.
Can't write with my left hand, of course. 16 lives. Never thought it would actually self-destruct. It's blown to pieces.
Wonder why it self-destructed. But yeah. That's pretty much Crush 40 songs. We don't know when they're going to actually debut yet, although it's a thought that it may debut when they perform in Tokyo later this year. It's a thought, but I don't know. It could be an upcoming album. It could be something. But it's just known that right now they are working on three. They've been working on three songs, and it's not unknown exactly when they are. When they are going to work on it. I don't know, I may actually start up a call with the biggest guys at least once, you know. It's pretty crazy. Also, in case you guys are wondering, I will plug this now. The Sonic Show is doing a live stream of Sonic Adventure 2 and the Hero Story. Sonic Adventure 2's Hero Story. They're going to be doing that tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. UK /GMT.
Nice.
And Turbo just commented about what I just said in the chat.
Okay, brilliant. We'll work with that.
I'm pretty pumped about tomorrow's stream. I'm gonna make sure to attend it. So I'm gonna be busy this weekend. No doubt about it. I've been having a busy weekend, and I got some of the work on that you guys will not be able to know until it comes out, because it's a part of something. I'm not gonna say what it is, but it's a part of something. God, goodness knows when it's gonna be out. Well, I do know when it's gonna be out, but. You guys don't, so fuck you. No, not really fuck you. kidding. I'm just doing a lot of plugging now. Why not? That's all I've been talking about. Anyway, episode... Or not episode. God, I'm used to the YouTube lately. Topic 5. Videos of Sonic 4 Episode 2 gameplay was uploaded. Yes, even more of them was uploaded. Even more concept art of Sonic 4 Episode 2 was, shown. Why is this becoming a normal thing? Well, because concept art is because it's supposed to be happening every Friday, and the video is just because there's been the demo has been showing up in locations, so especially at GDC. Who knows when that's going to happen? That's supposed to be happening right now. I'm not really that, pretty much. Nothing much. The footage did kind of hint. It did also hint at the improvement in the physics, so this is a good news. As for part 6, I don't know how much longer this concept art is going to last, but I imagine it won't be for much longer, because we are now getting near that window of time, you know, where things kind of, it's kind of in the way, so to speak, you know. Yeah, and Turbo's really having difficulties. I'm kind of hoping he manages to beat that level before the show ends, so that way he can tune into. That's not helpful. So I'm gonna try to go as slow as can be, but I'm also gonna try to make sure I'm done within an hour or so. I did say or so to the guys at SP that was in the call with just before I went out of the call to do this show, so. It doesn't matter anyway, because I'm kind of at the halfway mark of the show already, so with that in mind, let me bring this up, as I always do when I'm at the halfway mark.
Holy crap, half of the show gone already? Time sure does fly. Hey, Tails, are you related to time? Never mind.
Oh, and the second there we go. One didn't activate. Okay, then.
So, yeah. We're at the halfway mark. Although, I'm really going to take this halfway point, the second half, and just go slowly. I wish more of you guys were actually, you know, watching, but okay. I think it was just one of these, weeks. You know, it's kind of a slow Saturday. And that's the message telling me to get into the call, but I'm not gonna get into it at this time. Yeah.
It's the blue laser. Don't do that.
Pretty much. I guess number part 6 is gonna be episode. topic 6 is actually going to be rather odd because it has something to do with Dancing with the Stars. Yeah, Jay Leo White is gonna be on Dancing with the Stars. And if you don't know who Jay Leo White is, and you probably weren't around in the 90s when Jay Leo White was voicing Sonic in Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog and Sad AM and even Sonic Underground. Yeah, it turns out that, well, he's going to be on Dancing with the Stars. It's unknown exactly when Dancing with the Stars premieres, and honestly, I'm not going to watch Dancing with the Stars. I hate the show. I hate shows like it, such as it and American Idol, so I'm not going to be watching Dancing with the Stars, even though Jay Leo White's going to be on it, because, like I said, I just I just, you know, I just don't care about the show as a whole. It's nothing against Jaylee White, I just don't like the show he's gonna be on. Nothing against him, Jaylee himself. But, yeah, pretty much. I don't really know exactly. Again, I don't know when the season's gonna start. But it's gonna have Jaylee White in it. Just, you know. But yeah. Moving on. Topic 7. This one's gonna be the long one because of what the topic is. Apparently, Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing 2. Yes, we have even more information on this. These rumors are just not going away. Which really convinces me more that this game is gonna happen. Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing 2. Apparently, on eStarland.com, there was a leaking of the game, or pre-orders were available.
Slow week, eh? Or maybe everyone's out, you know, or gone to sleep. There's a good possibility. Do your spin attack? Okay, there you go.
It's just, I don't know, like. I want to say this game is going to come out, no ifs, ands, or buts about it, but honestly, people, even now, it's still a chance that it could be proven false. But it seems to me, like, judging from all the information we've had so far, I think Sega is going to confirm it as true soon. I don't know how soon, but apparently it's not too far off from now. eStarland did remove their information on the pre-orders of Sonic 4, Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing 2, but it's unknown at this time whether they're gonna come back or what. It's just unknown at this time. But like I said, it's also unknown that this game is gonna actually,
there we go. Right.
It's unknown at this time if this game is actually going to,
tough. Very tough right now.
Actually going to, when it's going to come out, basically, and, you know, if it does come out. There's many questions that still have to be answered, but the number one question right now is if this game is even going to come out for true. Sega has yet to confirm it. There is no positive, there isn't positive proof, official proof. Like, you can't say, I'm sorry guys, but a rumor is still a rumor until Sega confirms it themselves, regardless of what the evidence is out there. I said this last week, and apparently I gotta repeat it again, because there's even more information on it. It's like, never ending. But, yeah, a rumor is a rumor, and it remains a rumor until Sega confirms it themselves. And goodness knows when Sega will confirm it, confirm the status of this rumor. Whether the game's really out there. But if Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing 2 does end up happening, if, and only if it turns out happening, I will definitely get the game. I enjoy the first one.
Okay.
The first one has been a really, really enjoyable game, and I cannot see why people, I honestly want to say it's slightly underrated, slightly, because I don't really know exactly what people have been thinking of the game, but generally it's been positive. People have really liked the game. But I still think there's still a few who just complain about it just because of the announcer. I wouldn't have a problem if the announcer returned, to be honest. If the announcer returned, I wouldn't have a problem, to be honest. Because if the announcer was actually, I guess they were saying, people were saying he's in the way, but honestly, I didn't think he was in the way. It's just like how a regular race would be. There would be an announcer in it. You know, it's pretty crazy. It really is. But yeah, Turbo Cam's still going. He's on the last level, but judging by how much he's struggling with it, I don't think he's going to get it done before I finish the show. Unfortunately, so I probably would have a few more viewers once his stream ends, but the way it's looking,
come on.
But yeah,
Don't do that.
I won't actually cause problems, you know. I don't think there was going to be a stream at the same time. I don't think Tori's doing another stream at the same time next Saturday, if there is a Sonic News show this next Saturday. But I am aware that it's going to be something, you know? I mean, it's going to be crazy. I know I used to play, like, music in the background, too. I just now realized that. I used to play music in the background. It's just, there really hasn't been any motive for me to play music in the background as I get off topic because of my ADD, but, yeah. I keep forgetting about that. It's not anyone's fault. It's just, like, it's more mine than yours, guys, but anyway, I'm kind of disappointed how slow this week has been, but it's what I kind of expected. You know, I kind of expected it. But the fact that I've been hanging around between 3 and 5 viewers isn't bad. I think I see Wax is in the stream now. I think he's going to be streaming after me. Assumingly. But yeah. I think I know what he's going to be streaming too if he does stream. But, I'm not gonna be streaming much longer. Like I said, it'll probably be for another 30 minutes, 50 minutes, somewhere around there. I'm assuming, like, don't know right now. Just know that the Sonic News show is not anywhere near done yet. Although I'm nearing the latter half of the topics. So I'm going to go ahead, get to the next topic, because Sonic All-Stars Racing 2, I don't know what's going to happen, but I hope Rystar doesn't end up being a character. You know, I hope they do change the roster slightly in the game. Not completely, but slightly, so the main, you know, of course the Sonic characters are still in there, but I would like to see a few differences, like about 4 or 5 different characters in there. That would be nice. But I won't be angry if that doesn't end up being the case.
Another team blast will do it.
But yeah, moving on to topic 8. Ken Penders' lawsuit against Sega and EA got dismissed for now, but apparently Ken has actually come up with a counterattack by claiming something. There's something that, I forget what it was, but there's something in the contract with his contract with Archie that may have messed it up, but I don't think there's anything to worry about, guys. I don't think Archie's in trouble over this, because technically the whole thing is still claimed by Sega. They're all still claimed by Sega.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Still claimed by Sega. I mean, still claimed by Sega, and I'm getting concentrating because he's near the ladder. He's at the final part of the level right now. He's very close. Holy shit. Hang on, he's almost done, guys. I just want to he's at the last part. Oh yeah.
Wasn't fast enough. Okay, so
and now he's all the way back.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. 40 now.
Yeah, he died again. Wow, he was at the very end, too. Whoops. I did not mean to bring up that much stuff. There we go. But yeah, everything is owned by, oh, he's actually still at, oh, he's actually right here. Yeah.
Worth it, but hey.
Wait, I just want to get quiet. I just want to see if he can get past this part.
Blast through it! There we go.
Oh, he blasted through it.
That's blown up.
That should be the end.
That's not the end, though.
Oh. Oh, ooh.
Goal rings in sight.
He's almost there. Holy shit. He's almost done. I don't know if he's gonna... Hopefully he beats these two guys. I think he's got this, but yeah. While we're watching him try to... While watching him try to defeat those two robots, but yeah, Sonic is, not that one. I still think all the characters are owned by Sega. I don't think there's anything to worry about. You know, nothing to worry about. No problem. But, there he goes. He did it.
People, is game over. Okay. Oh, this must be a glitch. Yeah, because it's playing the audio from the cutscenes, which is kind of weird.
But yeah, he finally managed to beat... wow, I got really quiet on that part. I just wanted to make sure he...
Everybody sing Sonic Hero!
Sonic Gyros! Oh, sorry, wrong lyrics. Wrong lyrics, Sonic Gyros! I couldn't resist it. Whenever I hear that song, I think of that Sonic shit animation. Just saying.
Now, someone was saying on GameCube it's muted. Yeah, it is muted on the Xbox version. It's just for the 360. 360 is confused. So the 360 is playing the audio off the cutscenes at the same time, which is kind of annoying. But nevertheless,
didn't know you could play. Wait, you can play Xbox games on the 360? Didn't know that.
Sonic Heroes Super Hard Mode, finally. So yeah, so I will bring up the bets and see who was closest. So, and Gerard has just started his stream. So yeah. I'll definitely want to...
Because we're Sonic Heroes! I didn't even think of that one. Usually I do.
Which was never gonna happen.
I didn't think of that one, but yes. This is a rather awkward Sonic News show with all the stream in the background, but...
14. Which, nowhere close. 28 from Strata, sadly. So, apparently, funnily enough, the one who was wanting this this copy of Sonic Generation, the Sonic Generation's official soundtrack, is Spotty Low, Grace, who's in the chat. So, congratulations, because I ended up in having 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 40 deaths.
Wow.
40 deaths, and...
Kind of funny.
Bet 45 and sent that to my email address and...
Talk about remarkable. And now I have 6 viewers all of a sudden. I don't even know where I got 6 viewers from. Goodness knows. But yeah, yeah, Ken Penders' lawsuit. Nothing to worry about, guys. Sega technically owns all everything that happens in the Sonic comics, it belongs to Sega. Technically. Not Archie. Mostly Sega, so I don't exactly see the problem here.
You know. What was it?
But I think that was
UK did submit a
But yeah.
Unofficial bids of, I think, about 43 or something like that. But he was thinking that I was going through the entire game for every character, which, obviously, I wasn't. I was playing through super hard mode. Only super hard mode.
So yeah, pretty much.
So, Spotty Low wins. Yeah, Spotty Low wins. Sorry, Kev. You know, you got it.
AUK.
Well, you didn't send it to the correct. You didn't send it to my thing. Anyway. So yeah. So Spotty Low wins by default. You know. So congratulations, Spotty Low. All these cutscenes. So yeah. And she's spazzing in the chat right now. Which is fantastic.
Oh god. And even better, it's live too. You know, on this on Sonic Paradox as well. Oh, congratulations.
We're Sonic Heroes. And it cut as soon as it was gonna say that. Anyway. There we go. So Spotty Low, just get in contact with me, just send in your send in an address so I can ship this ship the soundtrack. I did have other things. Thank you for playing. I thank you for playing thing. Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah, I never saw that screen before.
Yeah.
Damn, 10 viewers. Holy shit. So where did I get 10 viewers from? Okay. I got 10 viewers just randomly. Holy shit.
Off the game audio. Yeah, you have other. You are gonna be getting other things, including this "Too Hot for the Internet" Screwtack DVD.
What the hell did I do to get 10 viewers within like less than a minute?
One of the best internet web shows that came out. Name tags, which is kind of like a spin-off.
What the hell did I do to get 10 viewers within less than a minute, like less than 30 seconds? What did I do? Did I say the magic word or something? The complaining work this time? I don't know. But, hello to everyone that just joined. This is a Sonic News show, although albeit a rather awkward one, with the stream turbo cam going in the background. Like I said, I was in the middle of watching this when I remembered that the Sonic News show was on, and I decided, you know what, let's just go ahead and watch, have this go and do the Sonic News show at the same time, because, you know, I usually do have two things running at once every time I do a show anyway. So, yeah. I'll probably upload this to YouTube, maybe. I'll try to, at least. I'm glad it's been a long, non-stop stream, though.
Congratulations, Spotty Low.
I don't really know, like...
And, funnily enough, she was asking for,
Sonic Colors.
Sonic Generations original.
This isn't Sonic Colors. That Turbo was playing just now super hard mode of Sonic Heroes.
So anyway, like I said, do email your address to me, and I will be, you know... Yeah, luck of the
and that's twice now that's done that.
She had luck on her side. So yeah, and that's it. You know, I eventually get there. I would eventually get to the end. So that's coolios. Even with if I did add the other ones that I didn't broadcast, like, you know, going through again. You know, I think Spotty Low still would have won. So yeah.
And I'm down to 9 viewers. Wow. Again, I apologize if this is getting kind of nerve-wracking. I do apologize if it's annoying.
I wasn't reacting fast enough and whatnot. But at least this time I actually had the lives to continue and whatnot. And yeah, and I'm not raging so much now. So that's brilliant. Anyway, I will let SSF continue his podcast now. And I will leave you be. So, now... A little preview for next Let's Play. Being that obviously that was an Xbox original game.
Here he actually he knows about the Sonic News show. He knows that I'm doing this, you know, this show. I've been calling it a podcast because essentially it is one, just a live stream. And then I drop back down to 9-5 viewers. Holy shit, that is hilarious! What did I do? That's fluctuating like crazy.
So Jet Set Radio will be the next Let's Play I will be playing right now. So, yeah. I will head off now, and I will see you next time. So, until next time, This is Turbo for Turbo Drive Live Let's Plays here on Twitch TV. A little more calmer and a little more, you know, a little more closure as well. So.
Yeah.
Thanks very much for watching, people, and thank you for supporting, and thank you for viewing, and thank you for bidding, and all that jazz. So, take it.
So, with that in mind, we finally can kind of, you know, end the stream. You'll finally be able to hear me as clear as day. And suddenly I get another entourage of, viewers. Holy shit, what did I do? To those that are welcome to the Sonic News Show. Yes, this is this podcast I was mentioning, and that Turbo mentioned that I also have been kind of distracted with, you know. I don't know what did I do, but apparently Turbo's stream ended, and, I guess Turbo's not going to be able to get into the Sky Call. I think he's just going off the bed or something. I'm just waiting. I kind of want to see if Turbo is actually available to be in the Skype call. I'm all for being in a special Skype call. Give me an excuse to go a little bit longer, because I still have quite a bit to talk about. So I'm going to bring up the... Finally, kind of bring the stream out of the box. And where is it? And if Turbo's up for it, I can... Yep, he says he won't. I think we're gonna have Turbo join us live, guys. You know, the guy that has been distracting me from my damn stream, my damn show this whole time. Alright, here we go. Well, hello there.
Good evening, man.
Good evening. Ah, man. Thank you for making my show most wonderful show of all time.
Yeah. Oh, man. You wouldn't believe earlier, obviously, it was an absolute nightmare, but no, that second stream obviously was much of a help.
Yeah. Dude, I'm not any better than you when it comes to rage. I was raging earlier when I was playing Mario Kart Wii, and it was not fun. It was... just... yeah. And apparently Grace is now in the chat watching us, this call.
Oh, that's glorious.
Yeah. I wonder if Grace is still gonna be, excited in the chat over her newfound prize.
Grace winning the Sonic Generations official soundtrack, Blue Blur. I was. I really didn't think she would actually win, but no, my gaming skills obviously show that you know, it really was a luck of the Irish for herself. So yeah. Aye, definitely.
Yep, there she goes. She's spazzing. Yep, there she goes. She doesn't want us.
I'm just like total adrenaline rush after that last push as such.
Yeah, I was actually in near silence at that last part. Like, I was so like, they will actually say, my viewers will actually say, I was nearly silent while you were trying to go down those lasers, like, through those lasers, and it was just, is he gonna make it? Is he gonna make it? Because I hate that part. Even not in hard mode, I hate that part. Just because of how, like, you don't get it as much time to, dodge those things.
Yeah. I think I only died twice on that bit. I think it was either twice or once, but no, didn't really take too long. It was just obviously several parts. I mean, obviously, if you didn't watch the earlier part, which is on my Twitch account, which I'm currently doing some edits to the description.
It's great to see that you were still you're still up for a Skype call, though. I'm kind of surprised after what has been a busy day for you today with that stream.
I mean, after after that, I was fine for another call. I was fine for a call, really. So yeah, I mean.
Okay, apparently, according to Grace, she can't hear you, which is rather odd, because usually Skype goes just fine for me.
Is it on the... Let me check the stream, actually, because I got the stream open.
Oh, you do? Okay. Yeah. I don't understand, like, how it's not showing up. You should be very audible.
I'm a little quiet, yeah, so let me... My thingy open. Here we go.
See, this is what happens when you're not streaming. My viewer count jumped in just a few minutes from 5 viewers to 11 viewers.
Dude, doesn't show you. Goes, I bring in the views.
Yes. It's remarkable though. You say you're someone known, yet I had less viewers than you did on your stream. I mean, not by much, but it was still less than yours. Kind of remarkable, but yeah, in case those of you who are watching the watching our call are wanting to know, yes, this is going to be the last time you're going to be hearing me and Turbo in a stream, because we're going to be doing another one. But with someone else streaming this time, which is Disco Ponies, JAK Disco Ponies of the Sonic Show, and the Sonic Show is supposed to be airing tomorrow night. It's supposed to be going live, although technically tomorrow night is my mid-afternoon because of me being across the pond in the U.S. on the East Coast. So what is 8 p.m. to Turbo and Disco Ponies and various others in the U.K. is 3 p.m. for me, assuming daylight savings time doesn't mess that up. I swear to God, if it does.
Well, daylight savings time will change everything on the Sunday midnight, you know, or on the Sunday midnight. I don't know. My brain's frazzled. I think it's the Saturday going into the Sunday morning. Saturday to in going. Into the Sunday morning. So, yeah.
Well, let me turn up the speaker audio. Okay, now can you guys hear Turbo a bit more now?
Twit. Twittity-two-two-wah.
Sonic Heroes.
Oh, I had to sing while I was at the end there. I mean, God, you know. I had to, you know. It's,
Okay, now they say they can hear you. Do 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 do. But yeah,
That was quite a stream.
I really did feel sympathy for you at that one point with all that rage, because, dear God.
Yeah, of course, if people who didn't see the first part, which is on my channel, I was at Frog Forest, which is, I think, the 9th stage or 7th stage. It was getting to a point where I kept on falling because Knuckles' punches would constantly overshoot and, you know, send me to the pit below because of the platforms being so small. But that was the least of my problems. Other problems were, Sonic, for some reason, using the continuous kind of like team blast move, Sonic started to glitch and, you know, go down to the pits below. So I was really not happy at all doing that, and I was raging quite hard. And then when I lost my last life and tried to restart from my last point, it took me all the way back to the beginning of the super hard mode, right to stage one. So I said, you know what, we're gonna end it here, and I'm gonna try to get to Frog Forest again. And within an hour and a half, I got back to Frog Forest, and Grace was saying, "Oh, do you want to go again?" And it's like, you know what? Yeah, let's go again. So there we go. So I started again. And eventually got to the end. It was kind of annoying, I could definitely say, but nevertheless, we got there. We got there eventually. I mean, yeah. I have played it all the way through before one time, from, what was it? From years ago though, so.
Yeah, it sounded like me, like, everything that happened to you during that stream, pretty much it's something that happens to me. Like, everything will go right at one point, and it's like, later on, it's like everything just doesn't go right. It's like the worst luck. And then it ends up being, it's just, what does this game have against me all of a sudden? What did I do to it? And then, it's like, it doesn't help that when the I start losing lives and I get down to that last life, then I gotta add the pressure of, not being in the not having any more lives after that. And then when I find out I gotta start the whole level over again, I just want to throw my controller on the floor, only to end up later on playing it again.
Yeah.
It's like you rage like crazy, and then you want to get away from the game, and then it's like, why? I want to play this again? Just after a couple of hours after I just slammed my controller on the ground, not wanting to have anything to do with the game.
Yeah. So, yeah. I don't know if there has been a Let's Play on YouTube of Super Hard Mode, but yeah, I am not putting that on YouTube at all. No, it's like, that's 4 hours of agony.
Yeah.
And it was actually 6 overall, pretty much, so.
See, the thing is, you actually have Super Hard Mode unlocked. I don't. I only have the story beaten, not Super Hard Mode. And the way...
Alright.
Yeah, the way it's looking... The way I saw Super Hard Mode today, I don't think I'm going to unlock it now.
Yeah, it's the only thing... I mean, obviously, every time... Well, once you kind of, like get all the emblems and whatnot and have Super Hard Mode unlocked, every time you play the... main story and then complete the main stories, the final story, it would always say, now try super hard mode. And yeah, you don't really get that, thanks for playing thing after the end, even after you've completed super hard mode first time. No, you still get the try super hard mode, rah 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 rah. So yeah, it's kind of a dick move. For all that you get is a thanks for playing ending screen. It looks beautiful, don't mind you, but it's not all that's cracked up to be. Not for the pain and suffering, but of course, this time around, other people are getting more rewards than others, so, which is good.
I agree with what Gray said. It's like a big fuck you.
It is a big middle finger, really, right in front of my face.
I just don't understand how those glitches. I just don't understand the glitches. That's my problem here.
Yeah, those glitches, I've never really had that problem happen to me ever before. Those glitches coming up. It was really awkward to, you know, come across. So.
It reminds me of when I was playing Sonic Spinball mid-time last year, because last year around Sonic's birthday, all of us on Sonic Paradox actually streamed a bunch of Sonic games. I was playing a bunch of Sonic games as a big collab of sorts, and it was called the Project 20 Gaming Collab, which was announced kind of like last minute, like the announcement that is, which wasn't exactly our intent, and I remember playing Sonic Spinball during that. And it ended up being very glitchy. That's probably the glitchiest run I've ever had of Sonic Spinball. Which is odd, because I don't usually see that happen. I've seen the glitches. I know what glitches to expect. It's just, why are they all at once? Why was that happening all at once when I'm streaming live with a billion people watching the stream? Because it was quite a few people watching. But I don't understand it. I really don't. It's something about streaming that... It's just that streaming curse where you do great off-camera, but on-camera it's like... Ah!
Yeah. I see a lot of live Let's Plays like that, I think. Where it's just... You know, it's perfect on, like, playtests or your own kind of, like, recreational playing. But then as soon as you put a camera to it, or as soon as you're putting, you know, activating a capture card or whatever, it totally goes...
Yeah.
I'm totally going to screw you. I'm screwing you over. Just for you, just in front of all those people. You know?
Yeah, it's just another thing I'll never understand. It really isn't. I just wonder... If it happens to Jay, though, tomorrow, I'm going to probably laugh. Because it's just... I'm expecting it for some reason. Just the worst to happen to Jay tomorrow. That's a sad thing to say, but I'm expecting the worst to happen.
Well, you see, with Jay, Disco Ponies...
Yeah.
I mean, he's only playing it on... Like, there's no super hard mode there. If he was given Sonic Heroes... And he was told to play super hard mode on Sonic Heroes. I don't think he would get past the first stage.
I think.
Really, in all honesty, I mean, no disrespect to Jay, but, you know, he's not that experienced of a player. He's a good gamer, but he's not experienced. And really, I'm one to talk that I'm an experienced player, but no, I'm not. I'm not experienced. You just saw me on super hard mode.
Yeah, they saw you.
And, yeah, or you see the first part, and I'm kind of like I'm a bit cocky when it comes to gaming at times, and you also saw it on the second part as well, and yeah, I'm not, you know, it's that experience at times. I mean, I'm experienced in certain areas. I'm only experienced when I'm left alone.
Yeah,
and I'm left to my own devices. If I'm ever in front of people or whatever, I'm probably going to slip. I mean, I think one perfect example was the Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing Tournament that happened at Summer Sonic 2010, and for shits and giggles, I entered the competition. I got past the preliminaries, but when I actually had a full-on 1v1 kind of like match against someone, I totally fucked up. I totally fucked up one corner, and that was it. That was me, gone. But I was busy anyway. I'm on duty. I was on duty as well. So,
Yeah, I'm sure that didn't help either.
I had too much on my mind.
Yeah.
And I think that's the case with my run tonight on Super Hard Mode, where the run was just very, you know, it was just very, you know, kind of like so much going on. So much going on with the chats, many people chatting. And I had multiple chat IMs open. I had Skype on. I had MSN on. I had Steam on, but luckily no one called me on Steam. Yeah, I had so many things on, and I was looking at all these messages and whatnot. And of course, you know, my concentration was not there. However, when, obviously, like I said, when I had the stream off and I wasn't concentrating, and I had changed my TV to full screen the game, I just focused, and I wasn't dying as much, and I wasn't pissing off. I wasn't being pissed off so much. I was getting more lives, because during that first part, I had little more than 10 lives in that first part. When I got to Frog Forest again, I had 21 lives. You know, so I was kind of like, yeah, there we go. That's a perfect example of when you leave me to my own devices, when the cameras are off and everything, I'm good. I'm very good.
Yeah.
But I'm not godlike in any kinds at all. Even on my own, I think. I mean, it's just a good case of like luck, pretty much comes to me.
Yeah. Anyway,
babbling on too much.
It's all right. Like, I was kind of doing. It makes up for all the silence I had and watching your stream and then handling a podcast at the same time. So, yeah, it was kind of. I think they enjoyed it. I mean, I don't know. I'm kind of glad that I didn't get any complaints that the stream was getting in the way, like saying, "Oh, this Turbo stream shouldn't be up. You should be talking about Sonic and this." My podcasts have never really been about just me talking. If it dwells off into something, I let it dwell off. I don't actually try forcefully, you know, stay on topic in this case. Now, if, you know, I were to, say, have a show on Radio Sega or SegaSonic Radio, and I have been debating that, by the way, I don't think it would be, it wouldn't be the same case. Like, it would have to be done within an hour, and that's it. So I wouldn't be able to, you know, allow myself to dwell on something in this case. And I would have to make sure I talk about what I need to talk about and make sure it's done, like I said, done within an hour. And if I do manage to get it done within an hour, great, you know, that's perfect. But that's not the show I'm talking about, though. This show, I dwell on it as long as I need to, because there's no, I don't need to end at a certain time. Like, the general guidelines, I usually end within an hour or two, mostly an hour. But if I dwell on to 2 hours, even 3 hours occasionally, I don't have any problem with that, because there's really no reason I have to stop anytime soon, because this is just not the show that has any constraints on a time. Pretty much. And even if it was on, even if I did bring this podcast on SegaSonic Radio, it'd have to be, like, revamped. Like, it'd have to be completely different. No question about it.
Yeah, fair enough.
And like I said, I have been debating it. I still don't know. And I even tweeted, I don't know yet if it's going to happen. But if it does, I'll make sure to inform you and, you know, anyone else on SegaSonic Radio. Provided once it gets up and running again.
Yeah. Yeah, whenever that happens. I mean, it's hard to say when that'll be. I mean, I really was hoping for it to all be sorted, but it's juggled between, you know, getting it back up, it's juggled between three people pretty much, you know, so, and those three people, they got their own lives and they've got their own things, so, you know, I'm okay for, for it to be, you know, a little hiatus. I mean, the guys at Radio Sega, you know, Gavi, he's cool with me. He's cool for me to be there. So, yeah.
Yeah, I know who Forever Sonic is. I've been speaking to him every now and then, and I even guest starred on a Forever Sonic's Random Hour at one point late last year on Radio Sega. So I'm good friends with them. Although, as for Gabby, I don't have a Skype, but it's understandable. But I do have a, he and I do follow each other on Twitter, and he's a good guy. He's a great guy.
Of course, I know Resident SD as well from elsewhere, but it's good that he's still, at Radio Sega. He didn't do Sega Ages before, but now, what is it? I've told I used to work with him on a website called tfmx.co.uk, and again he was pretty much doing what he was doing what he's doing now, pretty much, doing like a podcast with music and stuff like that. But both of us were kind of, well, he kind of, like, I don't know if he went off on his own devices, but me, I was just downright just dropped from that website, and it's all right. I mean, I have Turbo Drive Live. I'm expanding that now, so expand
Yeah.
it onto Let's Plays and all that. Having like video podcasts for that as well. So it's all cool. It's all good.
Yeah, speaking of Turbo Drive Live, I may as well plug it while it was brought up. Yes, guys, Turbo's main event, if I could say that, is not just the Let's Plays, but Turbo Drive Live, which happens every Friday night at 8 p.m. GMT, which is 3 p.m. Eastern in the U.S. If you don't follow the GMT thing, and I don't necessarily follow GMT. It's like it can be confusing at times, especially like I said, around daylight savings time where the times can get a little mixed up.
Well, I always say UK time. So,
Yeah.
when you're just looking up for, what the UK time is, you just, it's easy enough to just check your computer and just checking the kind of like time settings, and then you can see what the time zone is because it tells you. Yeah.
Yeah,
But anyway.
but yeah. Basically, Turbo Drive Live is where Turbo talks about just about anything. There's Turbo's first impressions. There's a Sonic News Rewind, and among other things. And if you're fortunate enough, you'll get to hear Turbo rant like I did earlier with that damn game trailer's trailer, well, video.
Yeah, they did actually kinda address it on their recent Invisible Walls podcast at the very end, where it was kind of like, yeah, it's like they kind they actually did do actually think that Sonic Adventure 2 is among one of the worst blockbusters in the Sonic franchise. And yes, I know, it's kind of stupid. Yeah, so
It's why I don't trust critics. I go by games based on my own impressions.
yeah, I mean, I've bought bad games. I've played bad games. I mean, or poorly reviewed games, like Fist of North Star Ken's Rage. That was critically, panned, but I still bought it because I'm a big fan of Fist of the North Star, and it was my first time playing a Dynasty Warriors style game, and granted, I'm not a big fan of the game series, and I probably won't pick up any other, Dynasty Warriors games, but I bought it simply because of Fist of the North Star, and I was able to do all these awesome moves like the 100 crack fist, and various other moves as well. And playing as different characters as well. So,
Yeah. But since I see I have more viewers now, I may as well explain what has happened within the last hour. Basically, Turbo took over my show.
Yes, I'm a bad man. I'm an evil Scotsman, and Turbo is my name.
Yes.
So, yeah.
It all started when he was streaming Super Hard Mode of Sonic Heroes earlier, and even earlier that, which was off away from the show. But yes, Sonic Heroes Super Hard Mode—it's a bitch.
bitch. It's an understatement.
Yeah.
It's a sadist. That's what it is.
Yeah. And
it's an evil sadist that wants to drain your lives away.
Yes. But yeah. White Sonic, I do not have a dinosaur fetish. What the hell?
Where'd that come from?
It's in the chat. In the live stream chat. But yeah, basically, what happened was, I was streaming the Sonic News show, and it just so happened that Turbo was streaming some Super Hard Mode of Sonic Heroes for a contest for the Sonic Generations official soundtrack, and I decided, you know what, let's go. I may as well do show his stream during my stream, because, you know, I do believe he deserves some viewers. And then it turned out I had even less viewers than him, which made me facepalm so hard. And then it's like, right after he finishes streaming, what happens? My viewer count nearly quadruples in size. So apparently, not only did he take over my stream, but he also managed to take over the viewer count.
Yeah, I'm a bastard.
But that's why we love you, Turbo.
Yeah.
If it weren't, Jay needs someone to say he did it wrong. I mean, I imagine it's going to possibly happen again tomorrow. Who knows?
What's this? He deserves nothing if he knows what's good for him.
Yeah. Grace, he's kidding. He's kidding.
Lovely.
Apparently, Grace says you're sexy, Turbo.
I'm dying here. God, Christ.
Way to go, Grace. Not only have you been spazzing out, you made Turbo nearly spaz out from your calling him sexy.
Well, you almost killed me. That's what. I didn't spaz out. Dying on my own breath. Anyway. So yeah, what else would you want to talk about then?
There's still a few more things I was going to do in the podcast before you continued to take over the stream. I might as well call this the Sonic News Show Turbo Edition at this point. Or like Turbo Drive Live, guest starring SSF.
Nah, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah. By the way, if you ever do want to guest star in Turbo Drive Live, I'm all for it. If you ever want one.
Well, I don't really do any kind of like guest stuff per se. I mean, I did do an interview with the completionist, Gerard Dragon Rider Khalil, and Greg Wilmont. Though that was a pre-recorded
thing.
So really, if I was to have guests, it would have to be pre-recorded, and I'm not. I don't like doing the whole pre-recorded thing, because at time, like for that interview, it was about like an hour of me twiddling my thumbs until it's ready, and everyone was kind of like, "Where's Turbo? We want him to talk about this, that, and the next thing. We don't want this pre-recorded shite." So yeah, just don't have the decent kind of like utilities to do proper audio stuff, because I do it through Sam Encoders, my show, the yeah. Livecast show, at least. So yeah.
Basically, it's just not your thing, which I totally understand.
I mean, I tried it before. It didn't go too well at times. It just, and plus, it was much easier on XP to do than it is to do on Windows 7.
Yeah.
Windows 7 is just much more restricted at times, and you really need to have a better setup as such. So, it kind of sucks.
Yeah, and now I have a guy calling me sexy. This is wonderful. What has been started here?
Who knows? Who knows?
And now Grace says, "Donnie is sexy. His voice is making me sleepy." Great. I'm glad I could put you to sleep, Grace. Do I have a fandom? I don't know. I still honestly think Turbo has better fandom than me, if you could put it that way. Like,
I can tell you now, there are so many people who have a better fandom than I do. Really. You're probably one of them, because you're part of Sonic Paradox, and Sonic Paradox has got a lot of people who like them. You know, I'm part of the Sonic Stadium, yes. I'm part of the SSR, yes. I've worked at Summer Sonic, you know, for 4 years in a row, yes, but I'm still not as popular as everyone else, as you think I am. Yeah, because with even people like you know, to begin with, Grace didn't know who I was. In fact, most of the people at on the Sonic, you know, during the Sonic Show live casts didn't know who I was. You know, it was just common. It is just common for me to be quite the unknown. And like I've said before, I've been mistaken as Dreadnux before, twice, at two separate Summer Sonics. People thinking that I was Dreadnux because I wear glasses. Yeah, thank you. you've totally proven that. You know, not many people know me.
See,
so yeah,
I've actually been. I don't see how they're able to. Is the glasses alone? Maybe, but in terms of the entire, you know, you as a whole, and so is Dreadnux, I see a lot of differences. But I don't know how people...
There is a lot of differences, being that I'm about, you know, 7 pounds heavier, seven stone heavier than him.
And that his hair is all spiky.
Yeah, he likes to style his hair much better than I do. Me, I'm just straightforward.
Yeah, I don't really care about how my hair, what style my hair looks like. I think my hair is still kind of 90-ish in a way. But yeah.
So yeah.
I don't believe that was Griff. I don't think he was the one. Was there someone that yelled at us because we didn't stream the Knuckles briefs after Summer Sonic? I don't think there was. I know there was a real struggle in getting, make sure it was in on time, but yeah.
The thing about Knuckles briefs, I didn't know really what was happening with Knuckles briefs at the time, but from what I heard, is that it was given too late. Being that it was pretty much put on like a flash drive or something like that, or it was only just sent in an email like a day before or 2 days before the event, which at that time is completely wrong. You shouldn't be, you know, because we're pretty much trying to set things up, set the place up, you know, a day before the event. So the second reason, there wouldn't have been enough time to stream to kind of like streamline Knuckles briefs, because if it was shown, there would have been a little bit of controversy, because there was one joke in it that revolved something about a can of hash or something like that.
Oh yeah, I don't know which one you're talking about. It was one Big supposedly did. Sonic, yeah. I can't open this can of hash.
Yeah. And hash, obviously, is a drug. And, you know, we got parents there. They might be thinking, why are they saying that? You know, so it was just a, you know, a bad timing for that to be said. And I know, what was it, the Chio?
The Chio.
the Chio.
Yeah.
He was pissed off at, you know, why, you know, that wasn't shown at Summer Sonic and whatnot, but the Sonic Shorts preview was. The only reason why the Sonic Shorts preview was shown was it was given well before Summer Sonic was started, you know, before Summer Sonic started, and it was streamlined by AUK, so he took out the ones that were, you know, that would have been a little too bad or a little too, you know, insensitive or, you know, naughty or whatever, you know. It's not our fault. It's just it was submitted to us. Whoever submitted it was a little too late, you know. And I don't know who submitted it. It might have been the Chio himself. It might have been someone else in Sonic Paradox. I'm not pointing any fingers, because I don't know who. I don't know everyone in Sonic Paradox. I only know yourself and, you know,
yeah,
the Wax. But I don't talk to the Wax. I don't talk to anyone else, you know, in Sonic Paradox. And all I can say is pretty much sorry, you know, we didn't know, and second, we didn't find out until, like, you know, on the day, you know, that there were supposed to be, you know, a Sonic, a Knuckles briefs, thing. So
yeah,
So all I can say, in part of everyone else at Summer Sonic, as part of the Summer Sonic crew, we're sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
we can't do anything more.
Yeah. It's. I don't think it's really necessarily anyone's fault. It's just a bit of a misunderstanding, because at the time, Summer Sonic was still kind of new. I mean, it was only its second year technically, although if you consider 2006, that would be its third year.
Yeah. I mean. As its second live event, yeah, it was its second year. But as in Summer Sonic as a whole, I mean, the 2006 event was obviously that of, you know, online fan community kind of like stuff. You know, it wasn't the Summer Sonic that Sven was envisionary, you know, for the future as such. So yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, it was new at the time. People were still, I guess you could say, people were still getting used to the production of the convention at the time, and Sonic Paradox probably was the same way. They weren't used to Summer Sonic yet at the time. I think that was their very first year, actually, they had any kind of representation at Summer Sonic. So, you know, it's not really anyone's fault. It was just a simple misunderstanding. But yeah, I wasn't there at the time, but I do know, I've actually known about Summer Sonic for quite a few years now. Like, I still remember Summer Sonic 2010 with Crush 40, I believe. It was 2010.
Yeah.
Yeah, in 2009, I vaguely recall, but I think I actually did see a few videos at the time.
Of course, the Sonic Show has complete retrospectives of all of them, you know, from 2008 to 2011, so.
Yeah. But I do plan on covering Summer of Sonic again this year, because I did find out that Summer Sonic was happening again this year, but I don't know exactly how it's going to be covered. Maybe, like, last year, I kind of want to, like, do a team-up with Jay and see where that goes, considering he and I are now best buds now, and it just so happens last year, coincidentally, like a few months before Jay and I met, technically, we were doing the, met on the Skype. We were actually, I did cover Summer Sonic last year, too, and it just so happens that it happened, sorry, I got a message on Skype. Someone was, messaging me. It's been like, oh God, I can't believe I forgot what I was saying. That damn message threw me off. Shit.
Lost your train of thought.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I get that a lot.
That's right. It was me and Jay, Summer Sonic coverage. It was actually me talking about covering Summer Sonic, and it was just so happened to be a view of the Sonic Show's feed of Summer Sonic, because it that was the only view that existed, like, the only view, so naturally, being, you know, a news reporter of Sonic Paradox, I gotta cover something, and there's only one thing there that was really good to cover Summer Sonic with, and that was Jay's feed. So I went to there, and I think I kind of stretched out the screen, so it was not exactly, it was still kind of easy to make things out, but if they wanted to get a better view of what the camera views, they'd have to go to Jay's stream, and I made sure they don't, not to take away Jay's views. Like, I didn't want to do that, and I still don't want to do that, because I still believe everyone deserves their own specific views. Like, I don't want to steal everyone's views. That's just wrong.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess before I, what was I? Oh yeah, I was talking about Ken Penders' lawsuit when I started the call.
All right.
Yeah, it was about the, what was it, that case that they were doing with Sega and EA that...
That's still going on, isn't it?
Apparently it was dismissed for now, last time I heard.
Alright.
Yeah, it's pretty...
It doesn't stop Ken.
No, no.
For being an ass. I've heard it, and, yeah, Ken Penders can really just go fuck himself. Really, if he has that kind of, like, viewpoint on... how business has worked, you know, how business goes, you know.
Yeah.
To operate, to try to, you know, call the characters that you've kind of, like, created for the Archie series as your own, even though they're pretty much over-glorified fan characters.
Yeah.
As such. I mean, I'm not a big fan of the Archie series. In fact, I've not really kept up with the ever expansive plot, but I have heard certain things, like obviously recent things. But no, the main thing with Ken Penders, yeah, he can go fuck him. He can go die in a fire if he's gonna be that bitchy about his works.
The thing for me is Ken thinks he's gonna win this when really I don't think he's going to, because
I don't
Sonic...
think he'll win either. He's fighting a lost cause. He's not thinking straight because, you know, he thinks because he's made them, he thinks he owns them, but that's not the case, because he would have known that with every job comes a contract, and the contract has, you know, kind of like, you know, certain kind of like conditions to it, where whatever you create for this, you know, kind of like this product or whatever, it belongs to this company. You know, it doesn't belong to you, it belongs to this company. That's why you see, you know, with DC and Marvel, you know, with their different kind of like superheroes and whatnot, those were created by many people, and it's like Stan Lee and whatnot, and various other people. I mean, what was it? Frank Miller, who's very infamous, you know, in the comic book world, with his kind of like, you know, Dark Knight Returns, you know, Dark Knight 2 or something like that, where it was just totally think, but he, if he ever said, "Oh, that's my own," that's things like, "No, you did that for DC, and it's owned by DC. You don't own it," you know. So basically, Ken Penders is fighting a losing battle with this stupid lawsuit to try to kind of like copyright his own characters. It's a losing battle. Nothing said. Nothing more. He's just being stupid.
Yeah, it's just the way I see it. These fan characters are just not like these characters. He thinks they're his, but technically, everything's Sonic, pretty much. Maybe it's a little more complicated than that, but
well, everything that has been created for the Archie series is owned by Archie and Sega. More so for Archie, because they are the guys who are publishing this comic. And whatever has been written, or whatever has been designed or drawn up, or whatever, that has been for that comic is legally tied to that company who publishes that comic. Because there would have been a contract saying that any and all works that you have created for this comic is owned by the company that you work for.
Yeah,
Archie and Sega. Well, I don't know if it's more so to Sega, but Archie nonetheless. And because Archie is, you know, in agreements with Sega to do this comic, then Sega technically has all rights to whatever is being published in the comics as well. So that, and this all started because of the RPG Sonic Chronicles, the Dark Brotherhood, because of it involving kind of like the Archie universe with that game. Ken Penders started taking, what the fuck?
No.
Yeah.
So yeah. He's not thinking correctly. He's not thinking like a legal man, in all honesty.
He thinks he has a little bit more power than he really does. Basically.
He doesn't.
Yeah. I mean, it's just, he's just starting up something that really doesn't need to be started up.
He's only starting up fires for no reason. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, here's the point where normally I would go and play the week ahead, because I do have a segment called the week ahead on my podcast, but the thing is, I kind of don't want to do that, considering we are in a Skype call, so yeah, I'm just going to ignore that and just go straight to the topic, which really isn't Sonic related, but that tends to happen on this, you know, podcast, where if there really isn't anything to talk about there that's Sonic related, I usually just go about what's on the calendar coming up. And in this case, it's Daylight Savings Time and St. Patrick's Day, two of the most worthless things on a calendar this month, if not so far this year. St. Patrick's Day, yeah, now I'm going to care about that. Daylight Savings Time, I really kind of, it just is a minor inconvenience, really. And it kind of makes a little bit of, it confuses some people, I guess. It doesn't really confuse me much. But anyway, that's that. But here, I think this is going to be more of our territory. Game Gear games coming to the 3DS eShop. Yeah. What the hell, yeah. Sega?
The two titles that were recently announced through the Australian Ratings Board, being that of Sonic Labyrinth and Sonic G, or Sonic Blast on the Game Gear.
Yeah.
I don't know why. Really, I don't know why Sega, of all people, would want to re-release soullessly Sonic Labyrinth on a download service. I mean, Sonic Spinball, fair enough. Sonic 3D Blast, okay, it's playable and whatnot. But Sonic Labyrinth,
it's stupid.
It really is kind of stupid why they would want to license or try to publish that game online, you know, through an online service. It's really, I mean, I talked about this on my live cast, but I mean, why not Sonic Chaos? Sonic and Tails, the original Sonic and Tails. I am shocked that game is being so forgotten, because that is possibly the best 8-bit Sonic game that ever came out for either the Master System or the Game Gear. Some people disagree. Some people think it was Sonic and Tails 2 or Sonic Triple Trouble, as it's known. No, I think Sonic Chaos is the better one. It introduced the Rocket Shoes, and you know, it took that ball and they rolled with it. So, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why Sega are being idiots.
Yeah, it's just it's bad enough that the game is just downright horrible, but now Sega wants to bring this back from the dead on the 3DS eShop. I'm baffled at this. I really am. But if anything, hell, even bringing back Tails Sky Patrol and Tails Adventure, that wouldn't be a bad thing, considering Tails Sky Patrol and wasn't really released in America except on the Sonic Gems collection. But this is Sega we're talking about. This is
Yeah, I mean, I'd be more. I actually liked Tails' Adventure more than anything else. It was a nice twist to the platforming genre where it was kind of like RPG-esque kind of like gameplay, which I didn't really think it was too dismaying at all.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, but Sky Patrol, yeah, I'm not big on Sky Patrol, really. It was way too linear and a little hard in places, but hey.
Yeah, I just don't understand the whole logic behind Labyrinth. I just don't, and I
Yeah,
never will.
I've never. There's supposed to be like a secret ending or. Some special ending, but I've never been able to get it, and I don't know how, and no one else knows how. So, yeah, it's kind of pointless, quite pointless.
It is. It's the only Sonic game I have never been able to beat, just simply because of how stupid and
I've
hard and
beaten
just.
it. I have beaten it. It's just I've not gotten the true ending, whatever that true ending is, and I've never been able to see the true ending online. It's not anywhere, so
The true. I didn't even know the game had a true ending. Son of a
there is a
bitch.
true ending. It's just I don't know what it is, and because every time it's like you complete the game, you always get like you did not whatever, or and I don't know why. I don't know why it won't. I could do it. It just baffles me why Sega would still want to publish that game again. It's mind-boggling.
It's I just don't get it. Like, it's bad enough now. Now that I know there's a true ending in it, it just makes me want to play the game even less at this point. It's like, there's no
Yeah,
way I'm gonna get that.
it's definitely something you shouldn't really put yourself forward to. I mean, it's close to, super hard mode Sonic Heroes kind of like bullshit. So yeah.
It's just, my God. It just goes to show that the 90s were not always perfect in terms of Sonic games.
Yeah. Well, at least for the hand, at least for 8-bit Sonic games, they were not fantastic at all.
Yeah. But thankfully we had the Genesis games to play that made up for it, so. I mean, yeah. I wonder what if they're releasing Sonic, a bunch of Sonic games now. If that's three now, including Triple Trouble, but I wonder if they're gonna re release any other Sonic Game Gear games. I think yeah.
They probably will. Really, they can't release Triple Trouble without releasing Chaos, 'cause that'll be criminal.
Yeah.
For them not to, release Chronicles, Chaos at all. Sonic Chaos. Sonic Chaos to me is absolute 8-bit gold for the handheld or Master System. And I actually have the Master System version, so I know how cool it is. I know how awesome it is.
Yeah, it's
Although, funnily enough, I have never owned a Game Gear.
I actually own a Game Gear and a Sega Nomad.
I pretty much owned every single Sega system that came out in the UK, from the Master System right all the way up to the Dreamcast. But I've never owned a Game Gear, ever.
Coincidentally, my Dreamcast is right here, right behind my laptop, which I'm on right now, is my Dreamcast, and right beside me is my 32X, my Sega CD, and my Genesis. So I'm surrounded by Sega stuff. rather fitting, considering what I do on this laptop on a daily basis, but... yeah. I really hope they release the Japan-only Game Gear games on the 3DS. That's what I'd like to see. Like, Sonic Drift may have been a bad game, but it was only playable in one country, really. I mean, yeah. It would be nice...
at least we did get the sequel.
We got the sequel, but we didn't really get the original, which is unfortunate. But, I mean, I guess there's always Gems Collection for that. I mean, it's good to see Gems Collection has it. That's the closest anyone will ever get to owning the Game Gear, those two games, but...
yeah, I mean, another way of doing it is going through Sonic Adventure DX Director's Cut and doing all the...
true.
The missions and get emblems. All the emblems and all that, which I've done, so... it's a shame they opt them out of the Xbox release.
Yeah. I just don't know exactly... The DLC, like, on a side note, speaking of Xbox Live, the DLC... I'm really, really tempted to get it, but considering some of the DLC just happened to be of a certain Xbox 360 game that came out in a certain year, that was certainly rushed and had a certain kissing in it, but...
I still regard that as a guilty pleasure.
I do too. It's like, I still consider Labyrinth, like, much worse than 06, to be honest. Because, I mean... it's just, 06 has just something about it, like, that makes it better than Labyrinth, just because Labyrinth is just a bunch of freaking puzzles and just freaking annoying, where 06, you're pretty much playing it, it's going through a level. Like another Sonic game just happens to have flaws with it, a bunch of flaws, you know, but it still is a good game if you think long and hard about it. It just depends on your standards, I guess.
Yeah.
And God knows, I really, really wish they'd bring out the Casino Night DLC for Xbox Live publicly, but you know how that goes. At least they released it on Steam, I guess, but...
well, they haven't even released it on PlayStation Network either, so... Console owners are pretty much screwed.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of... sad, because it is, it's only a game of pinball. I don't know why.
I'm actually more pissed off that there's no additional levels. I mean, I think Sega just has a bad concept of
DLC
for the Sonic franchise. I mean, the DLC stuff for Sonic 06, the DLC stuff for Sonic Unleashed, they didn't really introduce anything new. They just edited the levels to a certain degree and whatnot, and that is quite annoying as such. Sonic Unleashed more so than anything else. I mean, Sonic Unleashed was just stupid, you know. The game was hard enough already. We didn't need, you know, extra acts that were fucking balls.
Oh God, the way that sounds, I'm gonna have a fun time with that DLC. I'm just getting it because it would be nice to have that extra content, plus it's Sonic. I mean...
yeah.
But there's no doubt about it, I'm saving my 1,200 Microsoft points for Sonic 4 Episode 2. I'm saving that because I do want to see how the game plays, and plus again, because it's Sonic, and it's a new game. I mean... pretty much any game with Sonic is pretty much a must-buy for me, just because of the fact that Sonic and I love the franchise, but, I mean, it's kind of like with Mario, I'm kind of a sucker for those games. I really am. Speaking, again, getting off topic, apparently Nintendo announced today that they're bringing a new Donkey Kong 3D game. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, there was Donkey Kong Country Returns, and
yeah.
Apparently that was good enough.
I think it was Pokemon Black and White 2. Yeah, I think that's the worst case right now than Donkey Kong 3D.
Well, that, you know, laziest sequel naming ever.
Yeah.
Nothing more.
Nintendo never really was great with naming stuff, especially recently. Like, New Super Mario Brothers. Yeah, I think we kind of get that it's a Super Mario Brothers remake. I don't think the name needed really to emphasize that.
Also for the 3DS, yeah.
And then they bring out on the Wii, they just stick the word Wii at the end of the title.
Yeah.
This is Nintendo we're talking about, though. Nintendo's complicated, really.
They're not complicated, they're just lazy.
Yeah. By complicated, I mean they're just, you don't really know, like, exactly. The standards people have with them, like, there's some who just don't care what game they bring a Nintendo game, what the gameplay of the Nintendo game is, they'll like it anyway. There's some that just would rather play Call of Duty than Nintendo games, and then there's...
Oh, they'll play Call of Duty over anything, really.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is kind of stupid.
It really is.
This generation of gaming, I mean,
it sucks.
Yeah, like all the young kids, they do nothing but
Call of Duty, pretty much, and
or ask about, you know. I mean, in my game store, you know, I had a kid who was wanting to find some games and whatnot, and I suggested a couple of titles and. His mother was there, and you know, she said, "Oh, 12s are fine, but anything above that, nope." And I was saying, "Well, this is good." And it's like, "Oh, you got Call of Duty 2, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, or Modern Warfare 3?" And it's like, "Oh, God, you're fucking 9, crying out loud. 9!
9 years old and playing a Call of Duty game. What the hell?" Just what the hell? I never ever played that kind of a game at 9 years old. In fact, I didn't start playing anything mature. Hell, I didn't start playing anything mature and like for my consoles until just recently. Literally, that is how much I didn't really like care about modern mature games for a while. I did play Brawl as much as I got it the day it came out. Literally, the day it came out, like, 30 minutes after Brawl came out, I got it. Literally. Melee I had when I was 12. Which was okay, considering it was pretty, the game was T for teen, and I was just about a teen by then. Like, I was only a few months away, so it wasn't really... It's a difference, though. Like, it's just a difference. I just don't, you know... I don't understand. This generation just sucks beyond any belief. It really does.
It's one track minded as well.
Yeah, I mean, to think I grew up in a time where a hard game was greeted with enthusiasm, and no one cared about DLC, no one cared about constant updates to a game, and the game came out, that was it. That's the game, right there. But now, it's like, this game is not enough. It's like, people are getting more and more ungrateful nowadays, too. Like, about what they get. And I hate that, because, I mean, as much as Sonic's stories are short, and doesn't take long to beat them, they have plenty to offer. Regardless. And I'm grateful for that. I just wish that people were just as grateful with other games too. Like, and had that kind of a standard, but unfortunately they don't. They think every game must have a million pieces of DLC and has to have cursing and be like Call of Duty, and it's just, I hate that. To think that wasn't the case 20 years ago. It depresses me, it really does. But these are video games we're talking about, so Video games aren't our life, whether we will like it or not, so.
Anywho.
Yeah. I don't know, it's just... I guess it just boils down to, you know, having fun. I enjoy games, whatever, no matter what. I'll enjoy the games myself, regardless of what other people think, mostly. But yeah, what did I mention? Have yet to mention? I don't think I've mentioned anything else. I still don't know if I really want to... I'm going to be honest. I'm glad that Jaleel White's on Dancing with the Stars, but I don't think I'm going to watch Dancing with the Stars. Because it's Dancing with the Stars. No offense to Jaleel White. I just don't care for Dancing with the Stars.
Well, you know, fine, he'll be only there because, you know, he did Urkel.
Yeah.
He's not there because he was
Sonic
the Hedgehog. No, he's there because he's Urkel.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone knows him as that. It's kind of stupid.
Yeah, I kind of wish he was more than just Urkel, because, I mean, like you said, he also did Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yeah.
And he did a great Sonic at that. I mean, I don't think his voice would be fitting for a game, but as for a cartoon, it's perfect.
I mean, I lost all respect of Jaleel White after Sonic Underground.
True.
The guy did not need to be voicing three hedgehogs. He was the Jason Griffith of fucking
Sonic Underground.
Yeah, where he was voicing three characters. That's stupid. And what's even worse is that one of them was a female.
Yeah, Sonya.
I fucking can't get that out of my head now. Because, funnily enough, it's close to his fucking Urkel voice.
Oh.
His older Urkel voice. Which is fucking atrocious. It's absolutely fucking atrocious.
I have my hands in my face and I'm just shaking my head and like, I did not think it was Urkel. Sonya is Urkel? Dear God, no.
Yeah, it's very raspy. It's like, Sonic! It's like, and you just put it next to Urkel, like, old like the older seasons, or like, the later seasons of Family, I think it was Family Matters, is it?
Yeah, that's what it was called.
And you listen to Urkel, and you listen to Sonya, it's pretty much the same fucking voice.
And that creeps me out. That creeps me out.
Anyway.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, we'll see how it goes. If he does win, props to him, I guess. I mean, yeah.
I highly doubt it.
Yeah.
I don't think he's a good dancer. He may be. He might be, but, yeah. Might have been back in the day, but no.
But yeah, on a positive note, because we've been, you know, bitching and moaning too much here. Yeah. I'm pretty pumped about those Crush 40 songs they're making. Like.
Oh yeah, the new ones. Of course, June put up Johnny's kind of like response, like kind of like synopsis of the tracks. Sonic Youth obviously was a pure giveaway of what that song's gonna be all about, and we actually saw the first
two lyrics,
first two verses, or yeah, first and a chorus.
The first two lyrics. I think it was "I've opened my heart, I've lived and learned."
Yeah, that was first things, and yeah, kind of like a giveaway. It's that's gotta be the Sonic tribute song as such.
Yeah, a year late.
Yeah, a year late. True.
I have high expectations, which is probably not a good thing, but this is...
I'm not giving high expectations on it. I'm just... You know, I'm just... You know... enjoying the fact that there's going to be you know, more content. And it's three new songs, which is kind of cool. And I don't know whether or not they're going to be with a Sonic track or they're going to be...
In an album?
In like a separate album or something like... I would love a separate album.
Yeah.
I mean, the Supersonic Songs one, the Best Of, Crush 40, that was a good one, but of course it wasn't really a new one. It had a cover and a new song, but other than that, it was just a Best Of album. But an actual proper new album would be awesome. You know, it's a shame that they've only got three songs in the works. They're not doing
like one in time.
Yeah, they're not doing like an entire album. But who am I to complain? It's bloody Crush 40. It's awesome. It's awesome in a can.
Yeah,
pretty much.
To get three songs is saying a lot. Like, we're getting spoiled now with these songs. Like,
fun fact. I was actually gonna spout a question related to the whole competition thing that I was trying to do before I did the whole Let's Play competition thing. I was going to submit a question of how many songs have Crush 40 produced since being named Crush 40. And, you know, that would have been a little too confusing because there's been many remixes and reorganized tracks and stuff like that done by Crush 40 and whatnot. So I didn't want to go with that question at all because I frankly don't know their discography very well as such. Probably someone out there has it to a T, but me, I couldn't be bothered trying to find out.
Well, considering I do have a group completely dedicated to Crush 40, although some of it is their Sons of Angels material, I have, counting Sons of Angels material, 33 tracks. Mm-hmm. One of them is the Sonic Boom remix they did, and that doesn't count the many, many remixes that happened to Open Your Heart. It's the original song, pretty much, and I see, coincidentally, Sonic Heroes is right up at the top. It's number one on here. As a matter of fact,
just because I just went through Super Hard Mode just literally 2 hours ago.
Yeah, it's got nothing to do with that. Horse people, you know, you're thinking of nothing here. You're thinking of something that's not there, you know. You know, but yeah, I'm showing actually my list right now through Winamp because I do have Winamp. That's my entire Crush 40 library, pretty much. 33 songs, soon to be 36. Assuming I think they're probably gonna debut the song sometime. I think they were supposed to go to Japan, like, they're supposed to have a concert in Japan later this year. I think that might be when we hear the song for the first time. Who knows? Oh, and 99 to Grace. 99 to Grace. I see she's leaving for a night, and that is Skype. Because I'm sure everyone wants to see my Skype. I'm sure you gotta go to bed soon, too, so I'm gonna try to cut this short soon.
Cheers, man.
Yeah. Cause I know, being the UK, let me guess guess what time it is in Turboland.
Turboland.
Yeah. Let me see. Well, it's 5 hours ahead of me. 3 a.m.
9 minutes past three, yeah.
There you go. I'm smart. yeah, it's 3 in the morning. There's one thing I hate at doing at 3 in the morning is probably being in streams and things like that. So
it's a Sunday.
Yeah.
It's a weekend. I'm fine with it.
Yeah. Plus, there is the fact that we may want to make sure we're well rested and ready to go when Jay streams tomorrow. So, well, technically later on for you. So.
Yeah. After a good night's sleep, I'll be ready for that stream.
Oh yeah, I'm hoping. I hope there's a. I don't know how long it'll take for Heroes story to go through, but probably just as long as last time, assuming Jay doesn't screw up. You know, like, at one point, I think he died like 20, 30 times in the final level. Something like that, because I wasn't exactly paying attention, considering I was still waking up at the time, because I unfortunately overslept, and did not even freaking know that there was going to be a stream. So, you know.
Yeah. What was it? Let's play. Yeah, he actually died. Obviously, if you check the highlights of... what was it? The stream. He actually died more times in the kind of like prison. What was it?
Prison Lane.
Not Prison Lane.
Oh, the one with Rouge.
Yeah.
Security Hall or something like that.
Yeah, Security Hall. He died more times than on that level because he was either getting himself killed or letting the timer run out. More time, and that's why that's highlighted on the YouTube channel.
I'm sorry, that fucking timer can go to shit itself in that
level. But I actually was able to complete the... I didn't get an A rank first time, but at least I completed the game, or completed that level, before the time ran out. 5 minutes
is
quite generous.
Yeah.
It's just Jay has no sense... He didn't have any sense of direction.
No.
And when I said... When I said to him in the stream, you know that spring that sent you straight up, the one that he actually did hit at one point, was completely...
It was off track.
He did not have it in his head. And then when he finally realizes what happens, it's almost time over. Which is stupid.
And, yeah. Let me see. I'm responding, messaging Grace on the group.
Yeah.
Sorry guys, if I'm being silent. Let me see, Saturdays and Sundays. I'm telling Grace when my streams are usually on. There we go. I just had to tell her that. The show's usually on Saturdays and Sundays at 1 a.m. her time. Because I'm seriously considering possibly bringing the show a little bit earlier, like a couple of hours sooner, so people across the pond in the UK... I always say across the pond.
Do you work on the weekend?
No, I don't work at all, unfortunately.
Well, bring it earlier.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about, probably bringing it earlier. I wonder if I'm going to have the same viewership. If maybe it'll bring more viewers, who knows. But it would be an interesting time change. And like I said, it would allow the people in the UK and overseas to have a better time chance in watching it. But I do admit it is on very late. I mean, considering it's 3 in the morning for you. But yeah. What can I say? But anyway, I think that should do it. I don't think of anything else to talk about, and I see that the guys at Sonic Paradox are actually getting ready to play a big TF2 session. Would you want to join us in TF2 Turbo?
Maybe. Contemplating. I mean, I'm not playing too much TF2 now. I'm playing lots of other things as well. So. But hey.
Who knows? You could just message me and. If you want to. I want you to figure out if you're going to or not. Feel free. Like, I'm not going to be on Skype anytime soon by the looks of it. I don't even know if I'm going to go to sleep tonight. By the time I go to bed, I usually go to bed around 1 a.m. my time. You know, it's a Sunday.
Yeah.
I mean, why not? Plus, I think I do have some stuff to do anyway, so. But anyway, one last time, you know, make sure to tune in to Turbo Drive Live, guys. It's on at 8 p.m. GMT, UK, time, on Fridays. Currently on Radio Sega, because SegaSonic Radio is currently off the air at the moment. And I can't wait for it to come back, because I love that Sonic music. And make sure to tune in for the Sonic Show tomorrow at 8 p.m. GMT. 8 p.m. sure getting a lot of love. 8 p.m. GMT, UK time. Also 3 p.m. Eastern, if you're not really following GMT and UK time, which I understand, but 3 p.m. Eastern time is Sonic show tomorrow. Disco Ponies is going to be streaming the hero story of Sonic Adventure 2, because I could kind of understand why he picked... You know, I could kind of understand why he picked Dark first, because Dark kind of gets into the story
actually,
earlier.
Yeah, you know why we chose Dark, or he chose Dark?
Why?
It's because I did a coin flip.
Oh, wow. That coin was just as important as us being in the call, apparently. Which is saying a lot. Apparently, yeah. I see four of us are going to be playing in TF2, so it won't be just me playing.
That's good.
Yeah, so you'll be playing with quite a few of us on SP. I kind of wish Jay actually branched off from kid-friendly games occasionally, but I could totally understand why. You know, considering he wants to keep it family-friendly.
It's not family-friendly if I'm on there.
Well, that's true, and also... and let's not forget the images of Sonic and Mario. The videos.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, and that one video of the roller coaster.
Family at all.
Yeah, and that one video of the roller coaster. I'm not even going to get into that. That was just disgusting.
I don't know why he was wanting that.
Anyway. Yeah. Of that, I think that was Kevin's video. Kevin was gonna upload AUK very soon, but yeah, that was that. Yeah, I don't want to see that image again of her that woman puking. That wasn't pleasant. Didn't help I was eating either, I believe. But yeah, I'm getting off topic again. God damn, I'm dwelling too much. Thanks for watching, everyone. I realize it wasn't exactly a Sonic News show you're used to, considering we had Turbo take over my show.
Yeah, sorry for that.
That's all right. I mean, honestly, I've had guest stars before, but I think yours is you were the first one I've actually. I enjoy talking to my fans, but I have no problem. I especially enjoy talking to. You know, SP guys when they're guest starring, and you know, people at Sonic Stadium, and I mean, I have no problem with that, because you know, I know I'm expecting sure conversations, and you know, they're especially fun. Like, I mean, I don't do them often, but they're especially fun. But yeah, If you wish to follow Twitter, if you wish to follow Turbo on Twitter, it is TurboXLR. I'm gonna go get some to drink after this, because I'm not with it. Look what you did to me, Turbo. Look what you did to me with your stream.
I'm sorry. God.
I'm kidding. I had fun watching you stream while I was streaming. It was a streamception.
Streamception.
Yeah. But yeah, are you still planning on streaming Monday now that you got a super hard mode done?
I might do. I probably might do. It really depends what happens during that time, whether I'm busy with other things. I do know that the next game that I will be let's playing is Jet Set Radio Future, which has to be done.
Yeah, because of the remake.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. So, make sure to follow Turbo on Twitter if you guys want to know when he's going to be streaming again, like I do, because, you know, I follow him on Twitter too, among a lot of other people, because, you know, I always have to make sure I follow 500 people. And I guess I should say before we log off the stream is congratulations on 100 followers.
Yes, thank you. on Twitter, that is.
Yeah, on Twitter. If it makes you feel any better, I don't really have that many followers or any subscribers on YouTube. Like, it's still honestly more than you, but not as much. I still don't... I'm never going to understand...
You got 200, so you got 100 more than me.
Yeah, I just passed 200, coincidentally. It just happened recently. So, I mean, I don't know. I think you'll get, I'm optimistic, you know. I think you'll get to 200, and I still don't get why you don't have more than me. I mean, I am on SP, but considering you've been around a lot longer than me on when it comes to being represented on sites and all that, that's what I don't get. Like, you should at least have a well established fan base by now, but and then you do deserve one.
Some people hate me.
I know.
Some people hate me, so.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't help that we have been getting quite a few new people at Sonic Paradox, so, like, a few people like Recorder Dude and Halo Mania PC among them, they have only been around for around less than a year, so, you know, they're not going to know a lot of the big, like, some of the figures of Summer Sonic and Sonic Stadium. It's kind of ironic, though, I actually did listen to Turbo Drive Live before I even became an SP member, so, which is kind of not really the standard, but I guess that's just me. There's a reason why I'm just, it's just me, I guess. But yeah, thanks for being on the show, Turbo. I mean, I mean, you ended up being on it through the whole thing, but thanks for being on it. You know, I mean, I do hope you get more viewers because of this. I really do. Because you do deserve them. But
I
yeah.
Hope so.
Yeah, I mean, I still don't get how you had more viewers than me, but during the stream. Considering my stream, this show has been going for more than a year now, so it makes it even more baffling that you have more viewers than me. But I don't dwell on it. Like, it's alright. I mean, I think you deserve the viewers more than me, if anything. But, you know. And I guess I'll see, if I don't see you for TF2, I'll see you for the Sonic Show tomorrow, then.
Yeah. I think it'll be just the Sonic Show tomorrow.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, it is late.
Yeah.
I can't blame the SP guys for wanting to play so damn late, but if they picked earlier, I probably wouldn't have been able to get the chance to dwell on this, but didn't help that I went even longer than I really did. I just realized we've been talking on the Skype call for an hour and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's longer than I expected. But that's what happens when... Guys, that's what happens when friends talk, you know? They have good, long... They have good conversations. What can I say?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, now my throat's going out. I hope I'm not losing my voice, because if not, I'm going to go... I don't know what I'm going to do. I just think I need to clear my throat as well and grab a drink. But yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. I'm going to actually play the finishing track here, which is... I'm actually pretty skilled with Audacity, I might add. But, you know, you do use Audacity for your stuff on Turbo Drive Live, right?
Well, not entirely.
More like a guide, so to speak, when it comes
yeah,
to...
Yeah, I only do it if I need to pre-record anything.
Yeah, that's what I meant, pre-recorded stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that seems fun. I just wish I had stereo mix on it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. Thanks again to Turbo for joining me. I mean, it's an honor to have you here, considering, I'm going to be honest, you're one of the people that inspired me to do this. You know, I don't want to even sound fanboyish, but, I mean, it's a true thing. Like, I began to do stuff like this because of SegaSonic Radio and the people I listened to, you specifically, because there really weren't that many shows on when I started listening to you. I think there was you, there was Blitz and Pieces. I know that. I remember listening to Blitz and Pieces, too. I still do listen to all the shows. I'm just listening to what was on at the time when I started listening to you. There was you, there's Blitz and Pieces... There was something else, too. Talk It Up wasn't on at the time. Realm of Awkward Banner, I don't think, was on at the time. I know the Sonic Hour was, although as rarely broadcast as it was still on.
Radio Redux?
Radio Redux, that wasn't on at the time. In fact, I think the first time I actually listened to it was last month or two ago, because it's just how rarely they did shows. Which makes sense, and, you know, Radio Sega, I only heard about, like, a year ago, like, not too long afterwards. I think it was because of Project 24, I think it was the name of it, the 24-hour constant broadcast marathon.
What? For SegaSonic Radio, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I did tune in for that, by the way. I wasn't able to last the whole time, but I was able to tune in. I think I saw heard two-thirds of it. Unfortunately, I think, I don't recall, I think I was, wait, yours was the first show, wasn't it? Was hour one?
Of the night, no. Mine was the last show.
Yeah. Because unfortunately I dozed off by it, because I couldn't stay awake any longer. I fell asleep right on the couch. Literally, with the SegaSonic Radio still playing. That's how tired I was. Admittingly, I would have stayed up if I could have. Because it was fun, like, it was fun. It really was, listening to you guys. But yeah, I'm going to shut up now, because I am getting too far into this, and I said I was going to close this ages ago. So, screw me then. apologies, guys. Yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you. Hopefully, you'll tune into the Sonic Show tomorrow night. You know, tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. GMT, UK. Tune in for that. You know, you'll be able to hear me then too. I don't know how it's gonna turn out. I don't know how Jay's gameplay is gonna turn out, but I'm expecting it to be at least better than it did in Security Hall. Has to be. I mean, we'll see, right?
Only time will tell.
Yeah. Time will tell. So tune in next time for the next episode of Dragon Ball Z. No, I'm just kidding. They had Dragon Ball Z in the UK, didn't they?
Sorry?
Did they?
Yeah, we had Dragon Ball Z. We had all of them. Only televised, though. Not DVDs.
That sucked.
Which sucked, yes.
Yeah. But, thanks for watching, everyone. Tune in for the Sonic Show tomorrow night, 3 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. GMT, UK. Make sure you turn your clocks if you're in the U.S. I don't know if that applies to the U.K. as well, does it?
Sorry? Yeah, it probably will.
On that note, then, I will see you guys whenever. I don't know if it's not for the Sonic Show, it'll probably be next weekend or the weekend after that, because I don't know when the hell I'll have enough to talk about again. But it won't take long, trust me. See you later, everyone. Have a good night. Want to say anything before we go off for true? Like, for good, Turbo? Anything?
Pajamas!
And on that note, good night, everyone.
Night-night.
Oh, God.
Thank you for watching the Sonic News Show.
That's loud.
This is Sonic Sega Fan 1991, reminding you to drink smoothies, eat chili dogs, and keep an eye on the Sonic News section of the Sonic Paradox Forum for all your latest Sonic information and the live stream for any gigantic breaking news. I will see you next time. Only a Sonic Paradox.
Because we're Sonic Heroes.